last financial year.
Okay, Sam, you hang in there. I've got many more questions for you, but for the moment, let's take a detour. Yes. Mr. Godrej is talking about his quarterly numbers. Sales
were up 17% and EBITDA growth was up 12%. GCPL is an important part in the consolidated results of GIL, and I will read out the other divisions of GIL's consolidated results. The chemicals business, which is a division in Godrej Industries, grew by 11% in sales. Godrej Properties had a EBITDA and PBT growth of 27% over the corresponding period of the previous year. And Godrej Agrovet, which is a private company but a subsidiary of Godrej Industries, had a sales growth of 12% during the quarter and a PBIT growth of 58%. So GAVL had a very good quarter. Nature's Basket, which is also a 100% subsidiary of GIL, had a 34% growth during the quarter. Overall, all the various constituents are doing well, and despite the low growth in the GDP, we expect continued good performance by GIL. Thank you for your attention.
Well, a lot of things are happening, and surely it's turning out to be a very busy Monday for us. So we just heard it from Ms. Adi Godrej on what has worked for Godrej Properties for the quarter gone by. Where is the stock? And, you know, even after the right issue, the stock has not done a whole lot. It has been in the longest bear market, and that is what a bear market could do. That's Godrej Industries for you. I want to look at Godrej Properties also, because Godrej Industries is the holding company of Godrej Properties. Now, if Godrej Properties does well, Godrej Industries will also do well. And Godrej Properties, even though it is from a quality corporate house, I guess when the sector is in a bear market, doesn't matter, good company, bad company, everything gets painted with the same brush. Sam, my apologies for that rude interruption. You know, too much stuff is happening this Monday morning.